Yeah. Oh. Yeah. From the west to the east side, everybody got a freak side. The content is appalling when they nice and pretty Ricky, what they call a class in session. Nay and Ricky stressing, trying to decide on who got the biggest breasts. For real though, yeah, this shit hella ill though. Yeah, but you gotta keep it trill, ho. Whether you a lady or a real ho, cause you're rocking with the get down. You're now rocking with the get down. Says you're rocking with the get down.
Hello.
Hey.
We are the Get Down on RMCOnLive.com. I'm Pretty Ricky.
And I'm Nene Nice.
And we have another guest DJ this week, DJ Escalay.
DJ Escalay.
Here he goes. Oh, gosh. I definitely haven't missed your drop. I wish you would get a new one. You've had that since 1922, ooh, as Ricky would say.
Ooh. Escalay is my DJ.
Oh, there you go.
I don't like that one, so yeah.
Can't wait for Lose last time.
All right. Anyway, let's go ahead and get our shameless plugs in. Once again, I'm Pretty Ricky. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Vine, and Facebook at Pretty Ricky, RICCI.
And you can follow me at Nene Nice, NaneNaeNice, Twitter, Instagram, Vine, Facebook, and of course, Christian Mingle.
I can't. Escalay?
Don't be trying to act brand new.
I am.
We're in a new spot now. I feel all like a brand new baby coming out the womb, waiting to get smacked on the ass. Pause.
First of all, let's make it clear. DJ Escalay is KJLH's DJ. Okay, so he knows how all this stuff goes.
So let him try and fool you.
I don't know what they're talking about.
Now go ahead.
Your boy DJ Escalay. Make sure y'all follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DJ Escalay. Real simple. Let's go.
And coming up later, we have, oh, before we even get into our guests, you can follow the show as a whole at the Get Down _ on the same social media sites, Twitter and Instagram and Facebook. And we have a special guest, intern slash, yeah, all of
guest
that.
Host.
Helper, Santa's helper.
Santa's helper.
Jay Ree. You guys may remember him from last week. He stepped in on the Battle of the Sexes, right?
Shout out to the fat girls out there. Hey, baby, you too, baby, you too.
Gosh. Hi, Jerry. Are you happy to be on the mic again this week?
Yeah, you know, something new for me. It feels good. Feels good.
This is the kind of things that happen when our interns are great at what they do, and we actually want to help promote them and keep them motivated.
So they want to stay down with the Get Down.
Right. It ain't just go get no water and sit your butt down type thing.
Right. No, not at all. Not at all.
Right. And later on, we do have our guests.
Miss Kamira White.
And in case you don't know who she is a comedian. You may know who she is, but for the people that don't, she's a comedian. So we're going to go ahead and test her skills a little bit later.
Because I'm just going to tell her to make me laugh. And then,
ma'am, it's not that easy to just do that.
Well, that's what I'm going to say. So she better be ready.
Okay, so let's go ahead and get right into the show because we have a lot of stuff to jump on. Okay, so first up, celebrity situations. I want to talk about Rihanna, Miss Riri, okay? If you have been under a rock or you don't really participate in social media, then you wouldn't know what I'm about to say. But first of all, I love Rihanna. I've always loved Rihanna. I love her free nature and the spirit about herself. She don't give a damn. She don't care about nothing. So today
free
she posts
nudist.
Right. She posts pictures on her Instagram today of her spread in a Brazilian magazine. Now I don't want to say the word wrong because it's a Brazilian word. It could be Lou or Louie or it's L-U-I. So if you get a chance to look that up on Google or something, then check it out. But the exciting thing about it is that she posted pictures of herself like semi-nude. No top on. You could see the
areola,
the nipple rings in her areola. You could just see it's like a Playboy magazine minus the bush.
Right.
So if you want to check it out, you can look at our Instagram at the Get Down _ right now, or you can look on RMCOnLive.com right now, and we have it posted up. I mean, she looks beautiful.
She does. You know, she actually looks really good.
But the one pose that I will say, because it's not really about her being nude. I'm okay with nudity. I think it's really sad that America is like one of the only countries that has an issue with nudity. You can go anywhere else and it's like people don't care. They damn near naked. But it's not that she was naked. It was that how she was posing. And then one of her poses, she's like bent over doggy style position with her butt tooted up. And it's, you know, I was like, okay, I see what you, you know. But what do you guys feel about? First of all, I already know what the guys is going to say.
I personally looked at them earlier and I thought she looked great.
Yeah.
I mean, I had no issue.
Say anything. My tie, she a little skinny, but that way that ass sticking up, like, God.
Yeah, she did that.
Excuse my language.
Yeah. She did that.
All the way until 9 o'clock.
A-S-S.
Right.
No, she did that, though.
As.
She did it real bossy, though, because she did it with, like a straight, like I don't care what y'all talking about with the hat on, with a drink. I was just like, yeah, that's what's happening.
And I think what she did, too.
Nice tan.
By posting it.
Right.
Is just saying, like, you know what? Before anybody else gets to post it, let me go ahead and post it so it's no surprise. And I think that's pretty dope. Because some people just wait, like, oh, we'll wait
but till
you know. Just,
you know. I feel like people shouldn't be surprised that she did this. You know?
I am. I'm very surprised that she did that.
Man,
I'm very, because she has never done that.
But I mean.
She's never done what?
She has never done a.
We've seen nude pictures of her before.
It doesn't matter.
I've seen a picture of her on the internet where her stuff was actually out.
Nobody's understanding what I'm saying.
No,
Rihanna
no.
has never done this before. She has never publicly did. An advertisement in a magazine, commercial, movie, whatever, where it's just like, this is what we're doing and this is what you're gonna do and it's gonna come out and everybody's gonna really see it, because everybody don't have the internet. Our grandparents, you know, don't have the internet. My mom has the internet, but she's not really hip to stuff like this. So it's like, you know, but everybody buys magazines. So she's never done this. Yeah, we've seen you know, pictures from cell phones. We've seen the video clips from her maybe like doing something out and about, but she's never did a publication where she is just like, you know what, here it is. Bam, take the pictures. They're here forever. This is what it is. This is me. This is like Playboy, but it's not.
Well, they got tired of her catching her slipping. She done did the see-through shirts before in public and all that.
No, it's because it's in Brazil. It's like it's a whole different country. An American magazine would never do that unless it was Playboy or no, they won't.
That's X-rated. No,
they won't.
It is.
He know what I'm talking about, but we do this back and forth because he has got to be difficult.
He's trying to argue.
Yeah, but he know what it is, and you know what it is. Like that would never happen.
That would never happen here. But I'm not surprised that she did it though.
And that's the cover, I believe.
That is
she likes the red one, right? We would never do that here in America.
No, you would never. You would never see any type of nipple slip on the cover.
Well, she's not from here, so.
Hey, I don't know if I like that tan line on her booty though. What is that, a tan line?
It is.
It is a tan
line. I think
line.
What they were trying to do was simulate a bathing suit, because if she had a bathing suit on, it's like the same thing.
Okay, well, what about this one then? Because I mean, I don't know.
Which one?
This top one. She already got bottom.
Oh yeah, I don't know. We got to talk to the editor about that. I don't.
We're gonna call him and be right back.
Well, kudos to you, Rihanna. No hate over here.
Not at all. She looks great. And I'm jealous of her tan.
And I wish you would have showed a little bit more, but it's okay.
Ma'am.
I'm just saying, a little perv came out. Okay, so moving right along, I want to talk about Nelly. Okay, so Nelly has been rumored to have been dating Ashanti on and off for years. We've known this, okay? And then lately, or as of recently, it was LaShante Heckard. You may know her from The Game. You may know her from the Game TV series.
She bad.
Right. You may know her from ATL. She played like the opposite of T.I.'s girlfriend. That was acting all crazy and, you know, deranged because she still wanted to be with him, yada, yada, yada. And she's an ex-video model. She did a lot of Neo's videos. So you just track that back, you'll know who she is. And she's very popular online. So, you know, her and Nelly dated on and off for a while. Now, they broke up, she moved on, okay? He supposedly went back to Ashanti, and she wasn't having it. Like, you know, you gotta get your life right. We not finna do this back and forth. So, don't quote me, but that's what I'm saying in my mind.
Right.
So, now he's doing something. He's going after a girl that I think that Floyd Mayweather would have an issue with. Because Nelly and Miss Jackson, who we spoke about last week, they went on a date. I believe it was a date to a basketball game. Okay? If you look on rmconlive.com right now or at the Get Down underscore on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, yes, you will see that they are at a basketball game. Floor seats. There's got to be a date. You don't take no chick to no basketball game and it ain't no date and y'all got floor seats.
Right.
Now they better watch it.
So that's what they're saying online, and that's why I want to know what y'all think about that.
I think he better watch.
Why?
Watch for what?
What do you mean for what?
She didn't take nothing from Mayweather. She left with the same thing she came with.
I mean, Mayweather.
A ponytail holder. Shit. That's a downgrade,
because at the end of the day, Mayweather still loves this woman.
He does.
We saw his Woman Crush Wednesday little, little shot. Supposed to be a little shot.
Well, apparently how Nelly and Miss Jackson even, like, I guess, hooked up to even talk to go on a date like that, he did the infamous making her his Woman Crush Wednesday. He did that with LaShante Hecker.
Does that work nowadays?
I don't know. It wouldn't work for me. Well, let me take that back.
Because if it was Chris Brown, ma'am, he would work.
If it was Nelly, Matt if it was Floyd Mayweather, okay? Oh, you want your Woman Crush Wednesday? What you want to do? I'm just saying.
I'll show you about that, Chris.
But if it was a regular guy, like, no, I'd be like, oh, okay, whatever. But they're not regular guys, and not in my life. So, yeah. Y'all feel away?
I don't think it really matters. It don't really matter. They weren't together that long anyway.
You said what?
They weren't together that long. They weren't together long enough for him to even care.
Who?
For Nelly to even care. Like, it wasn't like they was like some
Well, who wasn't together
Beyonce
long enough?
Beyonce and Hova type relationship.
Floyd and Miss Jackson?
Yeah.
Yeah, they were.
How long were they
together? They were together for years.
Yeah, they were together.
And they were engaged. Remember that. Yeah.
Is that the fights
club? Yeah, they were engaged.
Yeah.
So why they break up?
I watched the old fight today where she's standing up in the scenes.
Yeah, that was his main thing.
Because he ain't, you know.
They broke up because he is a cocky ass butt.
Wait a minute. Yeah. So they broke up because he didn't get to cross the line with her?
He ain't shooting.
What?
No, they was having fun.
Okay.
Yeah, they was doing stuff. I believe what
happened
was...
Okay, y'all got to fill me in during the break because I got to know what's going on.
I believe what happened was, from how I see how he acts on All Access, he is very cocky and arrogant. And maybe she didn't do something that he wanted her to do. Like, oh, no, you're going to do what I tell you to do. And maybe she grew some balls. Like, I'm not doing that, or you're not doing this to me.
Right.
And
it's just a thumb.
He said something about, like, oh, if I've been in this level for 20 years, how you going to come and tell me what to do? And I'm the one who got you to a certain level. He was referring to Miss Jackson.
Of course he was, but we don't know what he was talking about. But if he was talking about what I think he was talking about, I have every right. If you've been my man for 4 years and I've been through the trenches with you while you was in jail, I held you down, all that stuff. Because remember, she did that. She stayed around. Okay.
He did give her 20 stacks before you went. I mean, she didn't have to do much.
I can't.
He did head her 20
he
stacks.
He gave her like the best lifestyle she could ever have.
But wait a minute, time out. Let's are y'all trying to say that she wouldn't have held him down if he wouldn't have gave her no money?
No.
Girls hold dudes down all the time with nothing.
I'm saying holding it this a lot easier when you got 20 stacks in your hand, though. Shit. Oh, excuse me.
Okay, we ain't not gonna get anywhere. It's guys against the women.
I know.
I understand.
I can't with y'all. Because y'all always gonna be on his side.
Yeah.
Always.
But he's wrong. He's wrong.
Why is he wrong?
You gotta treat your lady with a certain respect that you wouldn't treat. The way you would treat your other girls, if you're gonna have them, you don't treat your main like that. You don't do that, period. And if she decides to have a voice, let her. Now, unless she walk around with a baseball bat trying to kick your butt, telling you what to do and how to do it, then that's different. But I highly doubt that was happening. Yeah. I don't think as a woman she would mess up her situation living as lavish as she was to over something. You know what I'm saying? Like, no, I don't think any woman would do that.
Maybe she got tired of the side pieces being.
It could be that
you
too.
You know, the side pieces definitely was in effect though.
Yeah,
far.
For sure.
He was in the house with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, real talk. He got his ex working for him.
That's what I'm saying.
But that's
like,
the point.
Maybe
she's tired
maybe
of
she
it.
Was, she was done putting up with that.
Yeah, like. Yeah. How would you
I mean,
feel?
And I feel her because as time goes on and time progresses
you
in a relationship,
stand up for you. Yep.
That and you get more feelings. Like, you want to eventually settle down and marry this
and
person.
And if you are engaged,
you can't marry somebody who has a girlfriend living in your house. I mean, you can, but.
But it's 4 years, though.
Unless she came in.
What do you
knowing?
Mean? You act like 4 years is nothing.
in this day and age, it really ain't though. Like 4 years, people get engaged for less.
4 years is something, man.
4 years is
even
that's
if you
wrong.
Got even if you got side pieces, 4 years is something.
Dude, trust people me. Get engaged after like a month. They want to move them. In after
and
2 months.
That's not everybody. That's some people.
Yeah,
but 4 years. That's a mass majority now. 4 years is that's a long twice. Time.
You're right.
Got engaged twice.
Right.
So. Got she got engaged twice. Leeway, a type of pull in there mm-hmm. for you to get engaged twice.
Right. So that's why I don't understand why people keep trying to take that credit away from her. Don't do that. That's not cool. That's not cool at all. She was around for credit, 6 just, months and I get it. But she
just
wasn't.
What?
She can get the credit.
She yeah, dating
she
Nelly.
Can get the that's credit.
And Floyd got to sit there and watch it in the meantime while he got his 20 women.
But like I was saying.
That smacking ass who he messing with.
And he repoed
the one he really loved. Is around here doing her thing. That's what it is.
And like I was saying, Nelly needs to watch his butt.
You think Floyd gonna do something to Nelly? Nelly?
Ma'am, I wouldn't doubt it.
He ain't gonna do nothing.
You know how we add on her.
Catch him slipping that fat burger in Vegas.
Okay, we have to shut it down quickly because we have a lot more to talk about. The time flew like really fast. So when we come back, we'll finish up celebrity situations and then we'll get into a few of the things about the Donald Sterling situation in the NBA. And then we'll get into the reality wrap up with Men and Nice. Ooh, and we'll make sure that DJ Escalade's microphone isn't messing up the feed here. We'll be right back to get down on armsandlive.com. Get into the mix with DJ Escalade. We'll be right back.
Yeah. Draft day, Johnny Manziel. 5 years later, how am I the man still? Draft day, Abe Wiggins. That other side, we stay winning. Oh man, you know I had to do it for you.
The get down.
You know I had to do it for you.
The get down.
Yeah. Suits and ties yelling out, pay the guys, man. I had to do it for you. You know I had to do it for you. You know I had to do it for you. Oh man, oh. Sometimes I laugh with God about how you can't stop me. I'm as dark as angel probably, but he still got me. Yeah, I'm getting mine, but still I better live. I set aside to make sure that my people getting by. Brunch with some guitar royals and my cup is all oil. You know it's real when your niggas will take the fall for you. All loyal, so you keep egging me on. And we gon' have to crack your shell just to prove to you you ain't hard boiled. Last night I tried some raw oysters. Man, that boy growing up quick. That boy knowed it. That boy singing on every song when he knew he could spit. That boy manifested it. That boy knew it was written. That boy did it on purpose. That boy know that they sh**ting on you when they can't get past you. You should've followed all my moves. You won't realize till after. And if I left the chance, I would've picked a name like Chance the Rapper. Yeah, no offense cause I don't know that. I'm focused on making records and getting bigger. Just hits, no misses. That's for the married folks. Tell them fix my suite up cause I'm coming home. I heard they talking crazy. I was out of town. You know they love to pop all that when I'm not around. But when I'm here, not a sound. That'll make me snap, jot it down. Go in the booth and lay a body down. Know some Somalis that say we got it, wallahi. Get us donuts and coffee, we'll wait for him in the lobby. And I gotta tell him chill. Sprite got me on payroll. Let that man live, they say okay if you say so. See whatever I say go. I play like I'm on Royce, no Conseco. No Oakland A's though, shout out to Beto. I think I'm on my A flow, just watch me paint flow. We all do it for the art, so I can never hate though. Sign off on more deals than a lawyer with a heavy case. How the game turn into the Dre show. Duh, what the f*** happened to so-and-so, where did they go? Too worried about f***ing in fashion, they go missing in action. And then you never notice they missing. On some Hunger Games, I would die for my district. Jennifer Lawrence, you can really get it. Yeah, I mean for real, girl, you know I had to do it for you. You know I had to do it for you. You know I had to, oh wait, sidebar. Left some beat at the end so that all of you just could loop it and get your lies off.
See me up in the club with 11 girls. Posted in the back, got my bangs in my grill. Brooklyn brim with my eyes sitting low. Never going here when they got that. See me up in the club with 11 girls. Posted in the back, got my bangs in my. See me up in the. See me up in the. See me up. See me up in the club with 11 girls. Posted in the back, got my bangs in my grill. Brooklyn brim with my eyes sitting low. Never going here when they got that. Every girl in here gotta look me up and down. All on Instagram, cake by the pound. Look at like the image every time I come around. G's up, tell me how I'm looking, babe.
What is up for you? Just walk my way.
Just tell me how it's looking, babe.
Just
tell me how it's looking like. I do this all for you, baby. Just take me and tell me how it's looking, baby.
Dance move, shake face, you remember.
Drop the bass, main the bass, get lower. Radio face, speed it up, I just go slower. I like trouble, pumping on the knees. The man ain't ever seen a booty like this.
Wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I done won me a trophy. A trophy. I want me a trophy.
DJ Escalade.
I just wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you're the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I done won me a trophy. Hey. Trophy. Hey. Trophy. I want me a trophy. A trophy. A trophy. I want me a trophy. 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 I want me a trophy. Just to make that better. Gotta put you in that bitches. Now you rockin' Perry Ellis. Then I leave with you. Only cause I believe in you. We get to banging on the walls just to piss the neighbors off. You in the 12-foot ceilings. I just painted through the hall so I can breathe with you. I wanna live my dream with you. You say that money don't matter. It's the times and the memories that are getting fatter. And I know it's because of me. I know it's because of me. I know it's because of me. Got you in custody. Whoever knocking at the door, they gotta wait till we finish. I know I started at the bottom, but that ain't what we ended. I just wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you're the perfect one. Girl, when I'm with you, feel like a champion. Ever since I got with you, I feel like I done won me a trophy. Trophy. I want me a trophy. I want, I want, I want a trophy. I want me a trophy. Trophy. I want me a trophy. A trophy.
And hit records on my demo. Did y'all boys not get the memo? I do not stay at the Intercontinental. And anything I got is not a rental. I own that mom. Figured out this shit is simple. My stock been going up like a crescendo. A bunch of handshakes from the fakes. But I do not wanna be friends though. I tell y'all motherfuckers, man, this shit not a love song. This a stripper on a mean rug song. This a boys forever hold a grudge song. Pop some champagne in the tub song. Just because song.
Dang, what's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. And they don't have no award for that. Trophies. Trophies. And they don't have no award for that. Don't come with trophies. Ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm smoking.
Been dreams with a suitcase. I got my whole country on a new way. She like, I heard all your. Stay where you stay. House so big, I haven't seen them boys in 2 days. Use a walkie-talkie just to get a beverage. I saw my parents split up right after the wedding. That told my ass to stay committed, f***ing credit. Check the numbers, I'm the one who really get it. I told y'all, motherfucker, it's not a love song. This a doing me and only God can judge song. I do not know what the f*** you thought it was song. Pop some f***ing champagne in a tub song.
What's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. And they don't have no award for that. Trophies. Trophies. And they don't have no award for that. Don't come with trophies. Ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm supposed to.
Down.
Get Down on RMCOnLive.com.
Yes.
I'm Pretty Ricky.
And I'm Nene Nice.
That was DJ Escalade on the ones and twos. We have Mr. Jay Reed here with us. He works for the Get Down. So we're going to get his comments very shortly. But I want to finish up celebrity situations right now. And lastly, I wanted to talk about the Donald Sterling. And I think I'm saying her name right. V. Stiviano.
Yes.
Okay. The AKA the man looking girl.
Yes. Okay. She has very like chiseled cheeks.
Like, something
like
right.
At the jawbone.
Chiseled cheeks.
Her jawbone is like real. It's like real defined. I don't know.
Okay, but if you check out RMCOnLive.com right now or at the Get Down _ on Facebook and Instagram, you'll see the picture that I posted up. And I did a split screen type picture because if you notice, V. Stiviano, who is the girlfriend, or maybe the ex-girlfriend now of Donald Sterling, who is the current owner of the Clippers. Los Angeles Clippers, but he may not be any right for that much longer. People, I'm echoing. Can you cut one of those mics off over there or something? I'm sorry. I have to interrupt to tell you that. Because that was getting to me. Okay, there we go. All right. So I wanted to talk about that because a lot of people have been going in about her on the social media, period, okay? Now, I know people have not been up under a rock about this one, but I'll just go ahead and just do a brief
synopsis,
right, of what's going on. So, Donald Sterling, I don't know why I want to call him somebody else, but I'm not even going to go there. I want to call him Don Imus.
Same thing.
Right.
Don Imus, Don Sterling, same thing.
So if I get mixed up, forgive me. Okay, but Donald Sterling, he has been put on blast. His girlfriend, V. Stiviano, leaked a recording of him having a personal conversation with her within their home or his home, whatever. And he pretty much said, you know, that he said things that make him seem that he's racist. He made comments about her taking pictures of black people and putting them on her Instagram, that he didn't like that at all. Like, and he really went in about it, okay? So,
you know, he was the slave owner.
Right. He made specific names, like he didn't want her bringing Magic Johnson to the games. He didn't want her bringing none of her black friends to the Clipper games, okay? Okay? And it's also said that he is a slumlord. Him and his wife, not V. Stiviano, because she's the girlfriend, but he has a wife that owns the whole entity with him as well. And supposedly, or allegedly, he's a slumlord. He doesn't rent out to Hispanics or black people. And he made comments saying that black people stink, Hispanics sit on their ass all day and just drink, you know, stuff like that. So all this is on a recording, all right? Okay, so... Back to V. Stiviano. People want to keep painting her as like, oh, like the Chris Brown song, these girls ain't loyal and stuff like that. And I just, you know, I have to talk about the other side of the spectrum because people want to go in about how she wasn't loyal, how, you know, the side chick was the took down, you know, the millionaire dude, whatever. And I feel like at the end of the day, you cannot blame her. That recording should have come out,
exactly,
regardless of what she may have been trying to get, whether if it was millions of dollars or whatever. It should have came out. For guys to be like, for men to be like, oh, making it about the girl, that makes to me that you sound shallow and ignorant and immature. Like, you're so adolescent. Like, why is it about the girl? It's not.
Not
when
at
you
all.
Find out about this man and what his history really is, this dude is paying off the NAACP. I don't care what nobody say. He paid somebody in the NAACP to give him an award, a Lifetime Achievement Award, and was going
to
give him another one in
May. Get another one.
Right.
About to get another one.
But we'll get into that shortly. But back to this chick, okay? I'm not having her back or anything like that because maybe she is wrong for putting something out there that was between them two. But we don't know how their relationship was.
No, she was not.
He's a millionaire. He seems like a prick already from the stuff that we've heard.
Right.
So I'm sure he's even worse than that. He sounded like he was a jealous guy. He did sound jealous. I'm pretty sure his ping don't work. And he's giving her permission to mess with people behind the scenes, to mess with black people behind the scenes, but just don't show it. Don't show it for my friends to see. You know, because him and his friends are racist.
Tell your friends,
much.
Stay off my Instagram.
So, the gist of the story is, I don't feel like people should be blaming V. Stiviano for, you know, the demise of a man, of a millionaire that's a man. Yeah. No, he should have been put on blast a long time ago, no matter who did it.
Right.
Period. Period. He chose to have a side chick. He knew what was up. He knew what she was about, I'm sure.
You can't blame her. Like, if anything, you guys should praise her, because now he's out of anything within the NBA.
But he's still gonna be a landlord. He's still gonna be the same way. So it's just like, at the end of the day, it's not about the whistle. It's so deeper than her putting out a recording of the demise of a man.
Like, who cares?
She was 9 o'clock. Forget y'all.
Right.
Period. Yes.
Who?
Forget y'all. It ain't even about men. You know how I get when it comes to.
Yes, ma'am.
Because y'all ain't. Anyway. Okay. So that man decided to mess with a side chick.
You shouldn't blame her.
And she did what she did, and he got what he deserved because he is a horrible individual to be making those type of
accusations
and comments about any other race that is not white. Get out of here with that. So let's go ahead and get into J. Reed segment right now, because we're going to go a little deeper into it. Because I don't want to talk about her.
This is the man with all the answers.
Oh, I want a man's point of view. Yeah.
Well, basically, Donald Sterling. This is nothing new, first of all. You know what I mean? Like you said, he has like a history of doing certain stuff. The former general manager, Elgin Baylor, for the Clippers, he was a black guy.
Right.
Mm-hmm. He had his salary frozen at like $350,000 a year or something like that. And that was like super low for
someone in his
position. You know, the coach was making more than the general manager. And that's like unheard
of. What?
Wow.
Yeah, so he actually filed a lawsuit after he stepped down. He filed a lawsuit against Sterling.
And he lost.
But Sterling did have to pay $2.7 million to some black and Hispanic families because of that whole thing about him not renting
with
it to
the
them.
Apartments. Yep.
Yeah, he's not necessarily a slumlord, but he's like,
he don't want to rent to anybody ethnic.
Yeah, he don't want to rent to no black people
no
in Koreatown.
What's funny, I heard that he was born and raised in East LA.
Yeah.
Interesting, though. That's full of Hispanics. Nothing but Hispanics.
Yeah, he was an attorney
for
a long time.
Well, maybe back then when he was raised, there was nothing there.
Well, that's true. Maybe because he is like 102.
Right.
Yeah, 100. Literally. Yeah, he's the longest tenured. He's the longest tenured owner in the NBA, you know?
Yeah, because he's old. Never mind.
Yeah, he's old. His views, like you said, this thing don't work because he wasn't tripping on her having sex with black people.
Right.
But just don't bring them to the game.
Right.
And then he was hot because she took a pic with your boy Matt Kemp, too.
Oh, yeah. That's my boo.
She was hugged up with Matt Kemp, like, you know what I mean? But, I mean, he basically got banned for life from the NBA. That means no.
For the next 5 years, maybe. Because he's old.
Five months, the way he was looking. Next 5 months. Adam Silver is the new commissioner of NBA. Mm-hmm. And, like, hats off to him. Like, because he stepped up and did what he was supposed to do. Nobody saw that coming. Like, about the guy getting banned for life, $2.5 million fine. Nobody saw that coming. That's like, they were comparing him to Muhammad Ali earlier today.
But do you think that he did that because he had no choice? Because you have to think about the outcome after that. Like, if anything else would have happened, knowing L.A., we like to riot out here. Okay.
Well, no, I think he had a choice. I mean, the other commissioner, David Stern, before him, he wouldn't have did that. He would have just suspended him for the rest of the playoffs, fined him the $2 million. Okay, you back in the next year. This guy stepped up to the plate and said, look, we're not taking that. Sterling embarrassed the whole league. Right. He didn't embarrass himself. He embarrassed the whole NBA.
Yep.
And they wasn't having that. You know what I mean? He's looked at as a hero right now with the black people. Like, the Players Union, they're looking at him like, oh, he's the new Muhammad Ali. Like, he's like Martin Luther King. Like, they're comparing him to
I have
right
one
now.
Thing that I have to say that may go against what you're saying. Just one little thing about the commissioner. What is his name?
His name is Adam Silver.
Mr. Silver. I watched the conference, and he made a comment when a reporter asked him, you know, well, you've been knowing Donald for 20, you know, some odd years. You mean to tell us that you didn't know, you know, you knew the allegations about this man with past history, and you're saying you didn't know, you know, that he was this way? And Mr. Silver claimed that he had no idea that he was like this. You've known somebody for 20 years at Hoopla. No.
Yeah, but he wasn't in the position. He wasn't in the position to do it, though. Himself.
I know he... No.
He wasn't in the position to do nothing, though. Like, David Stern was still the commissioner.
But he shouldn't have lied. He should have said, yeah, I knew. Well, but he didn't do that recently while I have been appointed, so what can I do? Like, just be real.
But to hear that tape and to hear it like that, that was like something totally different. I mean, to hear a lawsuit about written to black people and to actually hear that tape coming out of his mouth, that's a whole different ballgame.
You think
know?
He didn't know? That was his friend. You think he didn't know? He knew.
No, he knew.
He knew.
Everybody knew. Just Google Donald Sterling controversies and it all comes up.
Right. That's they're trying to sleep under the rug, but now that it came out, they can't.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
He definitely knew.
Yeah, but he was like one of the worst owners in all sports. Like, the Clippers haven't won jack for like ever. You know what I'm saying? No, straight up. I'm not even. And, I mean, I'm a Laker fan and all, but I mean, I like the Clippers. Y'all in LA too, you know. But they've been one of the worst franchises since the 80s, since 81, since he took over, and before that. So it wasn't like nobody's sad to see the guy go. You know what I mean? Nobody likes him. You know what I mean?
Well, especially not now.
Yeah, nobody like the guy, man. Nobody respect him.
You know, and he needs to go do something with that belly and that.
did y'all hear Snoop Dogg's comments?
Oh, yeah,
now, that's my favorite. That's my favorite response.
Can't repeat it right now.
No, not right now. Not till after 9.
Right.
But yeah, Snoop let him have it for all the people on my side of town. So
there's been a lot of talk that everybody feels like the Clippers should like boycott and like not play and this is and that. How do you guys feel? Because I don't think they. This is the playoffs.
Well, now no. But I feel like they should have did something.
They did.
But that wasn't nothing.
That's all they could do. They're not finna miss no game check. And them game checks be like $400,000 a game, $200,000 a game. You think we don't even gonna miss a game check because of something Donald Sterling said? And keep it 100. If there was a microphone in a lot of people's houses, because he was talking to his female in his home when he made these statements. It wasn't like he was getting interviewed by the LA Times.
Yeah, what she did is illegal.
That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, but what I'm saying is, if you heard some people talking in their home, just it wouldn't be no owners in the league left, probably. It's a gang of people probably feel like that. He's just the one that got caught. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But he,
along with his rap sheet.
Yeah, he got the rap sheet.
Right.
Definitely got the rap sheet, though. But, you know, I'm
they could have, but they.
It was weak.
Answer the question. They could have did something.
It was weak.
They could have made a stand for black people, for ethnic people, for the minority.
The boycotts is temporary, though. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
It was
Jesse Jackson got up there talking about boycotts.
What should have happened was every black person in the NBA should have said, I'm not playing until he gone. And as one.
Something,
and that would have
been
more solid than them coming up here flipping inside their jerseys.
Yeah, like
that was like, it was cool, but it was like, come on, man. Like, we look weak in this 2014.
I feel you, dog, but it's like, dude, this is the best team the Clippers have had ever.
It don't matter.
And they're in the playoffs right now. Like, they're playing for themselves. They're not playing for Donald Sterling.
Well, can I ask you a question?
I mean, I feel what you're saying. I totally get that.
I hear that. Yeah.
I get that, because at the end of the day, they still have a family to take care of, and they get paid for this.
Exactly.
Yeah, right.
But here's my thing.
But they should at least release a statement. Something.
What if Martin Luther King would have been like, you know what, you know, let's do something. Let's just, you know, like, what if the people before us that paved the way for us to make a stand for ourselves was like, you know what, we're making this money, you know, so we just going to go ahead and we probably would still be like, in that situation now. You got to make a stand.
Martin and them wasn't making $200,000 a game, though. But
so what? If Martin was still around, nobody would have played that game.
I don't know, man.
Nobody
would have played that game.
Y'all see what I'm dealing with here?
I'm just saying. No, I mean, take a stand, cool, but boycott is only temporary. What they did, would ban him for life, fine him $2.5 million, which is the highest that they can ban, and he's encouraging all the voters to vote him out of
there.
Do
you think that's going to happen?
I don't know. I think it can happen. Because they got minority owners. I mean, not minority. They got owners from overseas now. It's a different league
now.
You know what I'm saying?
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
I mean, if it doesn't happen, then there would definitely be a riot, as you said.
Yes.
Nah, ain't nobody shoving on the Clippers. If it was the Lakers, then maybe. If it was the Lakers, ain't nobody tripping off the Clippers, man. You know what I'm saying?
Well, speaking of the Lakers, let's go ahead and talk about that top shelf life. Yeah, because Lakers live a top shelf life. They're the best team in the league. Nah, not right this second, but... Nah. They hold that crown.
Yeah, not for a while.
Against the Clippers, excuse me, sir. I'm not even gonna get into that.
No, the Lakers have really.
The Lakers got rings. And yeah.
They do. You're right about that.
And parades.
Yeah. Many parades.
The Clippers has
they got the inside
Sterling.
Out, the inside out jerseys.
I saw the funniest thing ever. I saw the Lakers hang banners and the Clippers hang selfies. And that's true. That's what's up in there. That's the difference. You
that's
see
what I said. Dude, one of the worst owners in sports. They ain't won Jack. They happy to see him go.
All right, so let me go ahead and get into this Top Shelf Life before we get into the reality wrap-up with Nene and Ice. The Top Shelf Life is a quick little segment. In case you guys don't know, it's involving Armadale Vodka. And we yes. promo and shout them out every Tuesday throughout our entire show. So first out, shout out to them, Armadale Vodka, because we want to eventually start living the Top Shelf Life.
Right.
You know what I'm
saying? Right, you know, that TMT life.
TMT
ma'am.
Life, right?
Yes.
Worldwide takeover. Hashtag TMT, the money right. team.
TMT.
You on the boat too?
Oh,
okay.
Man, I'm
well, I think everybody in here wouldn't mind working for TMT.
Right.
No one would mind that. Right.
Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and do some shout out some events that they have going on. First up, you know, you guys may not know. Well, you do know. Mayweather is having his fight this Saturday. Yep.
Who doesn't know that?
Right.
And if you don't, where have you been?
Cinco de Mayweather.
Oh, what's the other thing he said? The May code?
The Mayvinci code.
Yes.
Look at this fool.
Yeah, Money Mayweather.
Stupid. Well, you know, Jay Leon Love is fighting on his undercard this Saturday, so we want to go ahead and shout him out. Okay.
Give him a round of applause, even though my round of applause was second.
Round of applause.
Let me get a haircut.
Yeah. All right, yeah, so we want to go ahead and shout him out. He's definitely living the Top Shelf Life. He's, working under the
right
TMT family.
If you ever need help, we're over here.
Oh, you want to go ahead and just, you know, give a little speech for...
a little speech?
Yeah, you just said, sir.
Sir, if you're watching, would love to help you.
Thanks. Okay. So, anywho, Jay Leon Love is an undefeated boxer, and he's fighting for the title shot on the undercard for the Mayweather fight. So, and Armadale Vodka is actually one of his main sponsors. So that's a big
okay,
deal.
That's dope.
Hopefully, get down.
Go to one of the fights.
I'm trying to plug us in everything. Like, I'm like a hustler, like, trying to plug the get down for everything.
We can do it all. We
yes,
do it all.
We can do everything. Okay, and just so you guys know, Armadale Vodka also is like across the whole nation, not just here in California. So I'm in Houston. They will be at the Empire Nightclub watching the fight. So if you're in Houston and you want to watch the fight somewhere, go to the Empire Nightclub. I feel like every city has a club called Empire.
They do.
Because we used to have one here. And then it got shot up.
Yep.
So that wasn't
I think there's actually one out by me.
Right. And then there's in Miami, one of my favorite places to go.
Yes, we know.
Because their water
beach.
Is turquoise and warm, unlike LA. Hey, we'll be laughing.
Our water's like sludge.
No, the other day, though, it was pretty.
Yeah, it was cool.
It was pretty the other day.
It wasn't turquoise.
It was a little bit.
It was turquoisey.
You know what? It was turquoise. Your hair was reflecting off of the water, and that's why it was
is
turquoise.
That what it was?
Yeah,
that's
why. Okay, okay. It could have been. All right, so in Miami, let's see here. Okay.
Let me see.
DJ Spinatic. Is that
DJ
what it is?
DJ Spinatic.
I'm so sorry if I'm messing up names here, but yeah. So DJ Spinatic and Richie West and promoter Richard, though, let me see. First time DJing in Miami at Room Service Lounge. So go ahead and check that out. And let's see, in the Bay Area, the Wolves, girl, bye. Girl, bye. Yeah, we'll get back to that. Make sure y'all check out Jay Leon Love.
Where we are, technical difficulties over here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay,
so it happens.
Right.
Happens to the best, though.
Let's get into the reality wrap up. So I'm gonna make this really quick because we are kind of short on time. But I want to start with Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Oh, the reunion show.
And actually, I'll be talking about two reunion shows because we know that Basketball Wives had a reunion show this week as well. So Real Housewives of Atlanta. The first person I want to talk about is Mama Joyce. And if you guys see, up on rmconlive.com, there is a picture of Mama Joyce that says, I've been drinking. And I really think she definitely was. I think she drank before she came on the show.
I think she was nervous. Her hands was shaking and stuff. Like,
but she was so extra.
Yeah, she was.
She was so extra for no reason.
Annoying type of extra. Like, she was turned up to the max.
Yes. It was ridiculous. So then, a really part I want to hit on is when she had basically said that Candy don't take care of her. And then Candy is like, well, wait a minute, Mama, because you had a credit card in my name and I didn't even know about
it. Yeah, that's foul.
As much as Mama Joyce.
And she was like, that was only one time.
Like,
one time.
How many times do it take?
I know, right?
It should be no times. Yeah. Oh, if that was my mom, she would be cussed out. I would have to write her off. She couldn't be my mom. Like, get out of here.
That's a little harsh.
No, I'm for real.
That's that beige-ness right there.
That's not no beige-ness. That's for real. Number one, she had a credit card in Candy's name.
Yes.
And the way she be treating Candy and treats Candy's dude,
yeah.
You can't disrespect people like that. These are grown people.
Yeah, grown people.
You cannot disrespect people like that.
And where her husband at?
That's but you know what? Candy allows her to do that.
That's what I'm saying.
What can you do? But Candy couldn't be my girl because I couldn't put up with that. I would check my mom for making my man feel a certain type of way. You don't do that.
If I choose to be with him, then you need to accept him. If he's not beating me, then you need to accept him. Period. That's for real, though.
So if he beat you, then...
Well, then, yeah. You can step on in.
Yeah, Mama Joyce
I would leave, but of course.
Mama Joyce, something wrong with Mama Joyce, though. At least she's jealous of Candy or something, man.
She's lonely. And she don't want to lose... She don't want to lose her daughter. That's how I feel.
Yeah.
Is that her daughter is the only thing that she really has.
Since the son passed away.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
And she don't want to lose her daughter. So she's going to do whatever it takes.
But why make your daughter miserable in this at the same time? Like, that doesn't...
Exactly.
We'll see how it turns out.
Misery love company.
I mean, at the end of the day, Candy is going to... That's her mom. She don't care. She's like, that's my mom, man. And I'm like, well, you nice.
Girl, bye.
So let's move on to Nene. So Nene went in on Kenya on the reunion. And I think I had to rewind it once when I was at your house. Mm-hmm. Because she had told her that she's the lowest paying person on the show.
Yeah, I feed that.
Y'all heard that?
Yep.
Nene knows a whole lot more than people think she
knows. She got pulled on that show.
Nene definitely is the most successful.
She's been around since the show. The first season.
She's been on the first season. But she might as well produce the show now.
Right.
It seems like she
probably
do anyway.
Right.
I mean, she do everything else. So, what do you guys think Kenya makes?
$2.50.
$5 and some envelopes.
I'm gonna be honest.
$10 is okay, punchy.
This woman probably makes less than $120,000 a season.
You think so?
Nene makes $1 million.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Kenya made enough to lease that Bentley she pulled up in on that one show.
She had like a Kia or something on one of them shows, didn't
she? Her
Honda or something?
Her prince bought her a Bentley that she leased and she was going to get reimbursed.
Oh, her invisible man.
It ain't bought.
I can't wait for somebody to really like put her, to put her out there.
Dust bag.
Yeah, she's a dust bag.
What you heard when Nene said Miss Ratchet America?
Right. Yes.
Miss
Dusty America.
Yeah. Well, she got all that mouth, but you got dragged on the floor. Like,
I mean, Nene's hair was dusty. Nene's hair was dusty.
And Nene needs to do something.
I like Nene, man.
I like Nene.
No, I like Nene too.
That hair ain't it right now.
Her hair is really. I mean, her hair's not as bad as Jackie's hair from Basketball Wives,
Nothing's better. Nothing's worse than that. That bun, dude.
You got that twirl patent.
I don't know. Probably.
You got what?
The twirl.
She gotta find some way to make some money.
Miss Ratchet USA.
Kenya is, and she's so out of her mind. It was so funny because Nene was making a face at her when she was talking about people fighting. And he was looking at her like, girl, bye. Like, you evoked the fight.
Right.
Like, you're the reason why there was a fight. Cause with your little, what is that thing called?
The scepter.
The mega horn.
It's called a wand. Yeah. That little wand.
The scepter.
A scepter.
Yeah.
So I am curious to see what happens on the next one. There's one more, right?
The
third. Number three.
One. Right. Yeah.
Ain't gonna be no fight. I know that.
No, there's definitely not. Or else you would have heard about that.
I want to see NeNe throw some hands, though. Has NeNe had a fight?
No. She almost fought Kim, but.
Yeah. And then, Marlo.
I think she might put hands on. She might drop one of them. You know
not Marlo. She's not dropping Marlo.
Well, we haven't seen Marlo fight either.
That's
though.
What I'm saying. I want to see.
I feel like Marlo is more about it though than NeNe.
Oh,
NeNe talked that,
for sure,
but she don't. But she know who she can talk that with. She can talk that with Kim.
NeNe got a little size on her too, though. You know what I mean?
She a
got
lot
that,
of size.
That old crazy. School strength.
She has a lot of size on her.
Old school strength.
She got that strength. Like, 9 o'clock.
So make sure y'all watch the show next week because we'll be talking about the husbands because they're the ones who come on next week. And it's always good to see what they have to say because they always say something crazy. One of them is going to say something crazy. So let's talk about Basketball Wives LA.
Ooh.
This was actually my favorite reunion show.
Really?
Yeah.
Too much crying.
Well, I mean my favorite compared to the Housewives.
Okay.
I liked this one better.
Okay.
Only because Brandy did what she did and ran after Sunday.
Right.
And I don't know what Sunday thought she was doing with that shoe.
She can't fight.
Exactly.
Because if you take the shoes off so you can get better leverage, then that makes sense.
But right,
not,
but
not put it in your hand.
And then she had the other shoe on, and she was walking with one.
That's that old school fighting. That's that old school
she
type
took
of
it off, so she took it off so she could run faster, I think. And then they was like, it's cool, Sunday. Go ahead. You
but,
good.
You know, it still kills me how Sunday tries to justify
everything.
What she said.
Why was she crying at me?
There's no justification.
No, for no reason. For sympathy, but she's not getting it.
She was all crying on the show.
Right.
Sunday was crying on the show because she felt like she's, you know, people are always on her case about the things that she says and does and womp, womp, womp and blah, blah, blah. And nobody cares, girl. Bye-bye.
Exactly. And I was happy that Brandy stood up for herself and, you know, did what she did. Ran after her. I mean, although they didn't get to fight because...
Well, if it wasn't for that portion of the show, honestly, of the reunion show, I feel like it would have been boring. It was that was one of the worst Basketball Wives reunions I've ever seen in my life because it was boring.
Well, and I mean, Draya wasn't there. Right, Draya wasn't there.
Only just for the it factor. Like, I wish she was there because she, number one, is the best bitch on the show. Okay. Right.
And best looking, you mean?
No, because it's 9 o'clock. Best bitch on the show.
Oh, yeah. The best.
And,
you think she was scared? Like, is that why she didn't come on? Or, like, what was that about?
No, I don't think it was that. I think that it's sometimes hard around a group of people that are so argumentative to get word out. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I agree with her for, like, you know, having to sit down and so she can say whatever she needs to say to protect her and move forward.
But I always like to see, like, the interaction, like, the response to, like, what she said.
Yeah.
I like to see that live instead of, like, them having to watch her video and then pan back
it
to Sunday.
It kind of took a little bit of the sting out of it.
Like. Right. Right.
Okay. So let's talk about
Sorry
British.
That, ma'am. We got to end it.
Oh, well, we'll talk about this later. Let's get into the mix with DJ Escalade.
You guys, we're going to chop it up for now. When we come back, we're going to get into the uncensored part of the show. Okay,
damn.
So don't go anywhere. Come right back. We're going to get into the mix with DJ Escalade. And for the people that have to go now, see y'all next Tuesday, 8 p.m. on RMCOnLive.com.
Drive around at the partition, please. Needs to 45 minutes to get all dressed up. We even